Hi and welcome to TV Box Top, and on today's video I have another SSD enclosure from the brand that brought you the best selling model seen in my last video. This is the SZBox M182 10 gigabits per second multifunction USB Type-C M.2 SSD enclosure and hub. This one is slightly different from their first model as it seeks to address the issue of usability as well as provide some cool new features. So in this video we take a look at its design, the highly contentious issue of NVMe read and write speeds, its operating temperature, and its usability. So don't go anywhere, that's up next. So I'm back, and in the box contains the enclosure, one USB Type-C to Type-C cable, one USB-A to Type-C cable, and your user manual. So this enclosure has an all metal housing design with an easy release button to gain access to the M.2 compartment. It has a USB Type-C data port for connecting to your devices. It also has two USB 3.0 ports, a micro SD card reader, and a standard size SD card reader, making it a Type-C hub, only that it does not have an HDMI port. So to install your SSD, you simply press the button to separate the housing to gain access to its M.2 slot. It's designed to facilitate 2280, 2260, and 2224 sizes of M.2 SSDs. Unlike its previous model that uses a screw to secure the SSD, this one has snap-on clips for different sizes, making it quick and easy to install and remove your SSD. Once you install your SSD, simply replace the cover by sliding and snapping it into place. If your SSD comes with a heat pad, the cover has just enough space to facilitate and make contact. One of the major talking points about their first model is its usage when connected to a mobile phone or any device that has a USB-A or Type-C port. It was said that due to its male type connectors and the length of the enclosure, it would eventually lead to port damage due to excessive weight. Also, when connected to mobile devices, having a long, inflexible device connected to its Type-C port is a design flaw that would be awkward when applied to real live world usage. So in this model, they solved that issue by implementing a female USB Type-C port and included a pair of cables to provide flexibility. Another talking point, and I believe this one is the major one, is the data transfer speeds you can achieve using an enclosure. Meaning, if you insert an M.2 SSD with over 2000 megabytes per second read speed, can it achieve maximum data transfer speeds through the electronics of the enclosure itself? Well, there are three factors that can affect this result, starting with the class or grade of the SSD itself, the type of USB port it's being used on, and the speed of the electronics inside the enclosure itself. It's recommended that if you are using a high-speed NVMe SSD, to achieve maximum speed you should use a USB 3.2 Generation 2 port and upwards, or any grade below that will result in lower speeds. For my first test, I'm using a Kingston NV1 500GB NVMe SSD with a sequential read speed of 2100MB per second and a write speed of 1700MB per second. I'm using a RED USB 3.2 Generation 2 port on my video editing desktop PC. And using the Crystal Disk application, I got a sequential read speed of 877MB per second and a write speed of 814. So we see that there is a 41% loss in data transfer speed through the enclosure. And just to confirm, this is a Samsung 980 SSD that has a read speed of 2900MB per second when I tested it on an M.2 port and a write speed of around 1700. Through the enclosure, the results were the same. I got 877MB per second and a slightly higher write speed of around 851MB per second. So it shows that the electronics inside the enclosure has some restrictions. And just for a quick comparison to regular flash drives, these are the speeds I got when I inserted a USB 3.0 flash drive into the USB 3.2 Generation 2 port. So even with a bit of data loss through the enclosure, it's still much faster than a regular flash drive. And for those who are concerned about heat emanating from its housing, it runs very cool, not even hot to the touch, generating only 34 degrees Celsius of surface heat. So viewers, there you have it. In my opinion, I really like its design, making it easy to install your SSDs, and its usability and additional ports, making it a USB hub. So if you are interested, remember the brand SZBox, and you can grab one for a very low price of around $23 on the Amazon and AliExpress stores. See the link in the description below this video. And as always, give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed the presentation. If this is the first time viewing one of my videos, then be sure to hit that subscribe button and ring the notifications bell next to it to keep in the loop as to when I release new videos or decide to do a giveaway. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.